Hi, everyone. Welcome to MIT. I'm John Ochsendorf. I go by John O, and I teach structures. I have an unorthodox approach, which emphasizes history and culture and looks at a staircase like this 100-year-old brittle ceramic staircase in Pittsburgh as a source of inspiration for construction in the future. This was designed with no computers and no calculations by a first-generation immigrant with a fifth-grade elementary school education, and it gives you a sense of what is possible in construction. My interests are really focused on pre-industrial engineering. I began researching Inca suspension bridges, like this grass fiber bridge still found today in a remote region of Peru, absolutely astonishing work of biodegradable permanent structure made from this organic material, or the achievements of long span vaults in stone, brick, earth, and from various cultures around the world. The oldest arch I know, a Nubian vault that I was able to visit a few years ago in Egypt. And here, an abandoned subway station in New York City by Rafael Guastavino, the same immigrant family who built the staircase. And 20 years of research on that family's work has helped to expose their contributions to American architecture in a book and public exhibition, as well as major buildings like the Boston Public Library. And I'm not only interested in this for historical reasons or even for nostalgia, but because if we get the geometry right, we can use relatively weak materials to support high loads and to invent new forms in architecture. And this has really been the driving force behind our research and bringing it into practice in projects like this, with architect Peter Rich for the Mapungubwe Interpretive Center in South Africa, which in 2009 was named World Building of the Year, unreinforced vaults built from soil brick made on site, or more recently at the 2016 Venice Biennale with the Norman Foster Foundation, a similar idea, but using simple formwork to create complex geometry, earthen vaults that were largely constructed by two former MArch students, Luisel Zayas and Sixto Cordero, in a project in Venice which stood for 3 years. And these projects have dramatically lower carbon emissions than, say, an order of 20 times lower than the Bird's Nest, 4 times lower than the London Olympic Stadium. And this literacy around carbon and materials is absolutely vital for the future, as well as how we can build creatively within a carbon-constrained planet. Digital fabrication can enable new things like this project in stone with Haller and Yoon. 16 different MIT students from 8 different degree programs worked with us to bring research into this construction on our campus a few years ago, or former students developing lightweight floor systems from digital fabrication means at ETH Zurich. And I was very interested in low-cost earthen floor systems at the same Biennale. And a dry stone masonry vault, the Armadillo Vault, led by Philippe Bloch and his team, showing what's possible in complex geometry through research. And perhaps more importantly, the software tools we develop and that Philippe and his team grew out of his studies at MIT, became Rhino Vault, now used by people around the world. And amazingly for me, being used to build projects that we have nothing to do with. And so this is a recent project by Samit Padora in Southern India, which takes our research years later and applies it in a totally new context. And that for me is the excitement of working at MIT with students like you to develop new modes of building in the world. And I'd like to say that, you know, the students who graduate from our program, and this is a small selection who are now faculty teaching architecture and geometry and construction and really pushing the world forward, for me, are what make this such an exciting place to be. And finally, if we get a chance to talk, ask me about the Rome Prize. I just spent 3 years as director of the American Academy in Rome, and I'd love to help you get there for a year at some point in your career. So feel free to reach out to me if you want to talk, and hope to see you at MIT.